Hey everyone, my name is JP McEvenue. I'm the Executive Director of Roofing Operations for Semper Solaris. Today, I want to talk to you all about the most common roofing system that we install, which is an asphalt roofing system. An asphalt roofing system is more than just the shingles itself. There's several components that go into building this. Today, I'm going to walk you through each of those components and how it's put together. To start installing a roofing system, it's extremely important that we start with a clean barewood deck. So the first day of install, we're going to show up, we're going to back a truck or trailer up and start tearing off the old roof directly into the truck or trailer. Once all the old roofing debris is removed from the roof and in the truck or trailer, we can start inspecting the deck for any dry rot or damage. The best substrate for an asphalt shingle roof is plywood or OSB, like I have here. Once we've inspected and repaired any dry rot damage, it's time to move to the next step. The very first thing that goes on is an ice and water shield, like this one here. It's a self-adhered membrane, goes directly onto the roof deck, and self-seals around nail heads. This is installed in any water-sensitive area, around pipes, chimneys, in the valleys. In some parts of the country, it's installed on the whole perimeter of the roof to protect against ice damming. Luckily here in California, we don't have to worry about that. So this is installed in the valleys and pipes only. Following the installation of the ice and water shield, we are going to install your underlayment. We choose to use a synthetic underlayment as opposed to a more traditional organic felt, like this. Organic felts are a fabric or paper soaked in asphalt. They tear easily, they can absorb water, and they don't lay as flat as a synthetic underlayment like this. This is extremely strong, lays nice and flat. We're gonna have a more consistent final product. Also, it's made by the manufacturer of the shingles. So if there's ever a warranty claim, there's no pointing of fingers whatsoever. It's all covered as part of this roofing system. We've installed the underlayment. We've installed the ice and water shield underneath. Next component that gets installed is the drip edge. While not made by the manufacturer, it's still an extremely important component of your roof system. Typically, it's a 2x2 piece of metal like this, bent at a 90 degree angle with a little 1/4 inch kick at the end. That way, any water that runs off the roof is gonna wick off here and stay away from the fascia. Next up, our starter shingle. This is a starter shingle. It's really just a smaller shingle that goes on the entire perimeter of the home with a bead of sealant right here. What this does is it seals that first course of shingles and really protects against any wind uplift and makes sure that that's sealed tight. We have torn off your roof. We've put all the old debris in a truck. We've inspected the deck for dry rot damage, repaired any rotten wood. We've installed the ice and water shield, the drip edge, the underlayment, the starter. Finally, it's time to install. The shingle. Here at Semper Solaris, we prefer to install the Duration shingle from Owens Corning for a couple different reasons. It comes in a variety of different colors, including many cool roof options. But most importantly, it has this patented technology called Sure Nail. What you may or may not know is on most shingles, the area where you can put your nail is extremely small. Usually it's just a chalk line right on the shingle. Sure Nail technology offers a nice wide nailing zone. Really, it's a target that our installers can practically not miss whatsoever. That's important because we're gonna put about 9,000 nails into the average roof. We wanna make sure they're going in the right place. In addition to that, the embedded nail strip offers better protection against any nail blow through. So someone may have their nail gun set a little too high. It's much, much harder for that installer to overdrive that nail through the shingle, and we can better ensure that that roof is installed properly. In addition to that, this nail strip is designed to form a more secure bond with the adhesive on the back of every shingle. So much so that Owens Corning will give this roof a 130 mile per hour wind warranty with only 4 nails per shingle. Shingles are installed. Now it's time to talk ventilation. Ventilation is one of the most important parts of a roof system, and this has to be done correctly. There are two styles of vents that we can use. We can use an off-ridge vent, or we can use a ridge vent, which is located at the top of the roof. The main thing about ventilation is that it's done and that it's done correctly. A roof needs to breathe. We need proper air circulation throughout that attic. It's going to keep the temperature of the home cooler and prevent things like mold from occurring in your attic. I cannot stress enough the importance of a properly vented roof. To finish off your roofing system, we need to install a ridge cap. This runs across the entire top of your roof We usually install a high-profile ridge cap like this. Really gives it some added definition when you're looking at the house, some added pop and curb appeal. So that's an overview on how we build our roofs at Semper Solaris. Hopefully now you can see that a roof is more than just a shingle or a tile. It's a system of components that are working together to really protect your home from the elements and ultimately give you peace of mind that your home is protected.